Hello, I'm Marilyn Maxwell.
And I'm Dennis Weaver. In just 30 seconds, we'll be joining you as special guests on
Stop the Star. From Hollywood, the fastest half-hour in television, brought to you by the Ralston Purina Company, makers of Wheat Chex, Rice Chex, Corn Chex, with all three now available in Checkmate. Now, here's your host, Mike Snoky.
Thank you. Will you all sit down, please, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Stump the Stars. Let's introduce our six regulars, and we'll bring on our special guests, and we're going to have a special surprise for you tonight over here on the challenging team. And I may say this is 2 weeks in a row, gang, that you've been sitting over here, not winning. First, Miss Beverly Garland. Mr. Sebastian Cabot. And Mr. Ross Martin. Over here on the champs, and I can take the quotes away from it this time, because apparently they are, up to this point, Mr. Hans Conried, Miss Ruta Lee, Mr. Stubby K. Our first guest joining the team is an all-time favorite of movies, television, nightclubs, ladies and gentlemen, the glamorous Miss Marilyn Maxwell. Marilyn.
Marilyn, will you sit over here, please?
And guesting with our other team, well, one of TV's most versatile actors, a really fine actor, of course you know him mostly right now as Chester of Gunsmoke, Mr. Dennis Weaver. No limp? That's very good. Very good. The surprise I told you about last week, we took a portion of the show and did a different method of playing Stump the Stars that I had wanted to do a long time. There is no rehearsal on this show. Nobody knows what he's ever knows what he's going to get. But to get him ready for the show, in the warm-up room before the show, while one team is getting dressed, I work with the other and give them some of your postcards for them to get warmed up with. Then the two teams exchange places, and I hand the new team the same postcards. And what's interesting about it is to see two different stars attack the same single stumper one of you has sent in, and how each of them does it in a different way. Some things they do alike, some they do entirely different, and so on. So we're going to let you have a chance to see an entire show done that way. Instead of eight stumpers for the eight people, just four stumpers are going to be given tonight, with each team, each player from each team, tackling the same stumper. Of course, to do this, I have to send one of the teams out each time into a soundproof room. Through our doorway, they have these big foam rubber earphones. You've seen them before playing music. There's no video in any way, so they are completely blacked out, have no idea what's happening. You're going to enjoy it, and we'll start it in just a moment. I'm going to have your team go out. But first, here's Mr. Max Morath with a breakfast room ballad from Checkerboard Square. Ladies, please remove your hats.
One morning in Manhattan, at a swank hotel uptown, a cornbread gent named Sam Clement walked in and sat himself down, prepared to eat a classy treat. By the side of those city slickers, in the furs and diamond rings, eating omelettes and crepe soupsettes and other frivolous things caused Sam to stand with this demand. Bring me some corn sex, waiter. Bring me a spoon. That's how I start my day. I love their perfect square shape, I love their size, but most of all I love their flavor. It's corny, pour on the milk and sugar, corn checks stay crisp, a perfect breakfast bill of fare. Their new and delicious waiter, bring me a dish of corn checks from Checkerboard Square. Let me hear that crunch, corn checks from Checkerboard Square.
All right, as you can see, we have sent Hans's team out. They've got earphones on. They can't hear or see a thing. Miss Beverly Garland. Beverly Garland,
thank you,
ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
Bev, this is an interesting coincidence because just tonight you had to leave the Gunsmoke set to come over here.
Yes, I'm doing Gunsmoke, and he isn't in, so I'm doing him. You know, the lamp and the whole thing, and, you know, the accent is going.
Listen, you're also queen of the armed services week at
Yes, I'm in the strategic air command.
And that's open to the public at March
18th. Yes, on May 18th, and it's going to be fantastic. The planes and the... Oh, it's too much.
All right, watch Gunsmoke at March Field. Yours is sent in. Remember now, Hans is going to come back in and do the same one, Bev, so you guys get on the ball. Suggested by Felix Fisher, Hollywood, California. Wait for the bell. Good luck.
Beverly gets the gag saying, when the midget fortune teller escaped, there was a small medium at large.
Gag saying. Who won,
when?
Who won, when?
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 The
whole idea.
The whole idea.
Animal?
When
dog,
the dog?
Chipmunk? Cute
squirrel,
little what?
Squirrel?
Duck? What is it? A little girl. When the little girl, when the... Forget it.
When the...
Whole idea.
When the...
midget?
When the midget.
The midget? The
whole idea.
Looked, saw, peered,
read,
crystal
gaze. Foretold the future.
Fortune teller. When the midget fortune teller, whole idea.
Midget fortune teller.
Hid.
Saw.
Hid.
Left.
Disappeared.
Disappeared. Ran.
Well, what was it he said then?
The midget fortune teller. When the midget fortune teller ran.
The whole idea.
Risk.
When the midget puts in
handcuffs,
escape from the gate, sounds like here, there. When the midget puts in escape, there was, and there was, in, on, of, what, little, tiny.
Small wonder. There was small laughter, sound.
When the midget fortune teller escaped, there was a small hatch.
Whole idea.
Whisper, when the midget fortune teller escaped, there was a small medium at large. Bring the other team in, will you? Give them no indication, no clue of what happened here. When you want to do the whole idea, you do the whole thing, and then this means that several actions may be used in order to get over one thought. That is the reason that several times she called upon that. Will you come on in right away, ladies and gentlemen? Here comes Marilyn and Ruta and Stubby and Hans. Will you stay up right next to me, sir? Because, Hans Conry, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you would. Hans, you're going to do the same one. Sent in by Felix Fisher from Hollywood, California. Tell him about it, Bill.
Now it's up to Hans to match skills with Beverly on the same stumper. Remember, when the midget fortune teller escaped, there was a small medium at large.
When the midget fortune teller escaped, there was a small medium at large.
Until now. Will you step up for just a moment, Beverly and Hans? I want to let them watch your expressions as we tell you just who did what. You said and large, small, medium, and large. I didn't catch it. Small, medium, at large. Is that correct? When the fortune, midget fortune teller escaped, there was a small, medium, at large. All right, you two talk it over while I tell you what you did. And here are your times. Beverly Garland took 120 on 76 seconds. Oh, Hans, your team is ahead. Beverly, would you take your team out, please?
Please, will you go out right away?
So let's take a look and see who's ahead right now, shall we? According to the scoreboard, it's 44 seconds in favor of Hans's team. Ruta, will you step up, please?
Yes,
Ruta Lee, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
Ruta, here's a send-in by Jan Black from Kalamazoo, Michigan. Wait for the bell and good luck.
Ruta Lee must tackle a want ad. Author wishes to meet hula dancer. Object, writhing lessons.
Wait for the bell.
What is it?
It's a want ad.
Want ad.
Book?
Book?
A book.
Book.
A
book.
Line, line.
A writer. Writer.
Writer. Author.
Poet.
Author.
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 Wants.
Wishes.
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 Author
to
wishes
meet.
To meet.
What do you want to meet?
The whole
no
thing.
Idea.
Shimmy dancer.
Belly
hula,
dancer.
Hula,
hula
girl.
Hula girl.
Hula girl.
What?
Hula dancer.
Hula,
hula dancer.
Yeah.
Author wishes to meet hula dancer. Object.
Object.
Object. Writhing.
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 Oh.
Writhing books. Writhing novel.
Writhing.
Writing. Instruction. A teaching.
Writing.
Writing lesson. Writing lesson.
Writing lesson. Yes, that's it. Good. Very good. Nice going, Ruta. That's it. Author wishes to meet hula dancer. Object, writing lessons. All right, will you send the other team in, please? Whenever we have a want ad, as you know, come on in and sit down, won't you? All right, whose turn is it? Sebastian Cabot, ladies and gentlemen. Sebastian, you have the same one sent by Jan Black from Kalamazoo, Michigan. Wait for the bell and good luck.
Well, somehow I can't imagine Sebastian doing the hula quite like Ruta, but who knows? Here it is again. Author wishes to meet hula dancer. Object, writhing lessons.
Here we go.
It's
a one.
Full
idea. Full idea.
Writer. Letter.
Write like a writer. Author. Oh. Author.
Wants.
Wishes.
Wanted.
Wishes to meet.
Author wishes to meet.
Whole idea.
Girl.
Secretary. Dancer.
Dancer.
Ballet dancer. What? Is it a dancer? A hula. A hula dancer.
Hula dancer.
Object. Author wishes to meet a hula dancer.
Mabel.
No, two syllables. Wait a moment, two syllables. Like wavy.
Curly.
Snakey, snake hips. two syllables. Sounds like.
Right.
Right.
Writing. Writing. Writers. Arthur.
No, wait a minute.
Writing.
Something around the
what? Novel, author, story.
Two syllables.
Writhing.
First syllable.
Writhing. Writhing object.
No.
Object.
Reject. Sounds like.
Check.
Strike. Match. Sounds like match. Batch. Ratch. Catch.
Batch.
Latch. Match. Catch. Hatch.
Writhing.
Match.
Writhing.
No. Sounds like. What is that?
Ironing. Ironing.
I must say she was prettier writhing than you were on the thing. All right. It seems that Ruta, who went first? Ruta Lee took 44, Sebastian 109. Okay, sit down, won't you, for just a moment. 44 to 109, and I think that's something the opposite of what happened last time, isn't it? Let's go to the scoreboard and see. That means that Ruta's team is ahead by 109 seconds. Holy cat. Now, we'll go on with the second half in a moment. Now, for Checkerboard Square, here's Lee Goodman with a word of explanation.
In our commercials for Check cereals, we've been asking you to think of checks whenever you see the checkerboard pattern anywhere, like a checkerboard tablecloth, for instance. Now, some folks have claimed that we've been trying to hypnotize people into buying checks. And I want to state right here and now that this charge is absolutely untrue. Now, anyone knows that you can't hypnotize a person against his will. Besides, folks just naturally go for checks. There's wheat checks with a rugged whole wheat flavor made on purpose for grown-up tastes. And rice checks, light, modern little waffles of toasted rice. And corn checks, sunny cone kernels of crisscross corn. All three are bite-sized and all are keen tasting. Now, that's the only reason people buy them. And I'm sure that any checks lover will bear me out on that. Oh, here's a satisfied customer now. I noticed that you bought some Czech cereals there. Now, I want you to tell the audience, you were not hypnotized into buying checks, were you?
No, master.
There you are. You see, all people have to do is think about checks and they get hungry for them, just like that.
Hey, what's going on here? Last thing I knew, I was home watching television.
Yeah, all right. I'll explain it to you, fella.
What are these
big
lights?
Come with me and I'll explain it.
Fellow, people out there, television cameras.
Don't worry, I'll tell you.
Who are you?
You can see the champions are out. They have the earphones on. They can't see what the next player is going to do. Dennis Weaver, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah!
How are you, Dennis? Well, you will. Dennis, in addition to being a versatile actor and not having to limp or anything, I understand that this is going tremendously. Genesis through Exodus, your new record. What label is this on?
Warner Brothers.
Right. How did you happen to start to...
I don't know. I just wanted to do something different, and somebody came up with a piece of material that I liked very much, and it was exciting. I just dipped in with both feet, and there's where I am.
Well, you ought to hear it, because it is great. Dennis, here we go. Yours is suggested by Mrs. Dale Johnson. Manhattan Beach, wait for the bell. Good luck.
Guest star Dennis Weaver draws the song parody, the Indian cab driver's theme song, or I'll Be Down to Get You in Apache, Honey.
It's a song parody. Indian theme song. Automobile driver. Sport driver.
Indian.
Okay. Oh, locomotive. Wheel. Engineer.
The Indian. Wheels.
No, it's not a wheel. Some Indian steer.
The Indian Jaguar. The name of a car, Dennis. MG? It's like the name of a car. Yeah.
The Indian a Pontiac?
There
we go. Forget it. It's a locomotive, an engine. The engineer.
Indian engineer. The guy who drives the engine.
Oh, no, the bandit who jumps on.
Indian...
It's a backseat driver. Is it a cab driver?
Indian cab drivers.
Theme song.
Indian cab driver's theme song. I'll be down to get you in an Indian. The name of an Indian? An Apache.
Yes, yes. Very good, Sally. Very good. Send them in. Send them in. It's all right. Now, don't say anything. Don't give them any indication of what you just did on this. Very, very interesting. Let's see, who is going to be up? Marilyn Maxwell, will you step up right now before you even... Marilyn Maxwell, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, please put them on. Listen. Hans has been doing the play, The Critic's Choice, but your picture with Bob Hope and Lucille Ball is coming out in just a few days, isn't it?
Yes.
Did you enjoy doing it?
Very much.
All right, it's good to see you on the screen, doggone it, and in person. Marilyn, yours is sent in by Mrs. Dale Johnson from Manhattan Beach. Same thing Dennis did. Let's see what you do with it.
Well, it's up to lovely Marilyn Maxwell to go on the warpath and see what she can do with Dennis's stumper. Here it is again, the Indian cab driver's theme song, or I'll Be Down to Get You in Apache, Honey.
What is it? The song parody.
The song parody.
The
Indian.
Indian.
Indian. Love call.
The Indian.
Love song.
Indian.
Brave. Brave. Drive.
Car.
Car.
The Indian's car.
The Indian's car.
Car.
Sounds like car.
What kind of an Indian car is there?
The Indian car. The Indian car.
Hey,
a Rio. Pontiac.
Indian car.
Time. Windshield.
Metronome.
Indian speedometer. Gas steering wheel.
Gas
driver. Chauffeur.
Driver.
The Indian driver.
Chauffeur.
The
Indian chauffeur.
The Indian racer.
Bob.
Indian maid.
Indian policeman. No.
The Indian apple.
Driver.
Indian.
Yeah. Oh, I know what that is. Driving a car.
No, you've got the dashboard there.
Yes,
the taxi
driver.
Taxi cab.
The cabbie.
Taxi.
Yeah, the Indian cab. Cab.
Indian
driver.
The Indian cab driver.
Who?
Drivers.
Driver.
Indian cab driver. Theme song. Theme song. Colon.
Or.
I'll be down.
I'll get you in a taxi, honey.
I'll be down and get you in a teepee, honey.
Lodge, teepee.
I'll be down to get you in a Pontiac, honey.
In a Pontiac, honey?
Name of an Indian. In the name of an Indian. I'll be down to get you in a
Geronimo, honey.
No.
A little name?
First syllable is.
A.
A.
That's it. Come on up, Dennis. The Indian cab driver's theme song.
And they told me ours was going to be easy. That's what.
I love this. I'll be down to get you in a teepee, honey. Oh, brother. Stubby. All right, let's see how you stand there, shall we? Marilyn Maxwell took 114. Dennis Weaver, 104. So that was close. Go ahead, make yourself comfortable there. Let's go to the scoreboard now. See which team is ahead. Checkerboard says that Maryland's team's lead now has been cut down to 99 seconds. Now let's pause for a moment while Bill Baldwin tells you how you too can join in the fun on Stump the Stars.
And it's fun tonight, Mike. Thanks a lot. We invite you to send in as many stumpers as you like each week. We prefer postcards, and in case of duplication, the decision of our judges is final. Now address your postcards to Stump the Stars, Checkerboard Square, St. Louis, Missouri. Now, those whose names and suggestions were used on tonight's show will receive a Polaroid Land Camera kit, including the automatic 10-second camera with electric eye which chooses exposures, as well as carrying case, film, and flash bulbs, and a selection of American Tourister luggage, light and strong, with scuff-resistant covering, foam rubber padded handles, and stainless steel closures. And if you stump the stars, that is, if it took them the full 2 minutes, you will also win this world-famous Amana Friofrost Freezer, holding 525 pounds of food at even zero temperatures. Fast freezing coils giving contact freezing and no frost ever. So get those stumper postcards in the mail first thing tomorrow. And now, back to Mike.
Incidentally, while I'm thinking of it, next week it's PT-109. The Warner Brothers Picture Cast is going to be Challenge Our Regulars. You don't want to miss that, and we'll play the regular way. Meantime, Stubby K.
Yes,
Anchorman.
Sir.
Stubby K., ladies and gentlemen. Slide up, won't you?
How are you?
Stubby?
Anchorman.
Stubby, yours is suggested by Mary Herka from Parma, Ohio. Wait for the bell.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Well, Stubby has a wonderful one. It's a definition. Oriental ambulance. A six-shaw.
Definition.
Whole idea. Oriental.
Oriental.
Driver. Bus driver.
Whole idea. Sleepwalker. Sleep driver.
Driving in a hearse.
In a hearse.
Hearse driver. Undertaker. Funeral director. Mortician.
Oriental.
Is it a mortician? Someone who takes buries the dead.
Three syllables.
First syllable is.
Sounds like.
Hit. Clap.
Clap.
Smash.
Hit.
Stop.
Punch.
Suck. Smite.
Punch.
Smash.
Dear.
Sounds
Oriental.
Like.
Driver.
He's driving a hearse. Undertaker.
Ambulance driver! Ambulance chaser!
Indian.
Oriental ambulance.
Oh, Oriental.
Oh. Call it
Sick.
A sick.
A sick.
A sick.
Horizon.
Sick look.
Sick.
The whole idea. He's swimming.
Across the ocean.
No.
Swimming.
Shore. A sick shore.
Sick shore. Sick shore is what?
Say it right. No.
A sick shore.
Now you said it. You said sick shore first. All right, send the other team in. Don't give any indication at all. All right, gang, come on. And anchorman Ross Martin, will you step up right away on here? Ross Martin, ladies and gentlemen. Ross, here we go. It's versus you and Stubby. This is sent in by Mary Herka from Parma, Ohio. Slide up, won't you, Dennis?
Well, let's see if Ross can improve on Stubby's efforts. Remember, it's the very same definition. Oriental ambulance, a sick shaw.
It's mine. Definition.
Proper name. Far away.
Chinese.
Oriental.
Whole thing.
Oriental.
Sleeping.
Hangover. Sick ambulance.
Ambulance.
Driver. Ambulance. Cold.
Oriental ambulance. A.
Rickshaw.
A. Sick
shot! Come on up, Stuffy, quick. That is very interesting because, according to the score, Ross Martin took just 27 seconds and Stubby K, 86. 86 seconds. We'll be right back to see which is the winning team. But first, here's the latest breakfast news direct from Checkerboard Square.
If you're a person who prefers a smart, modern meal in the morning, be bright. Start the day light with Rice Chex. These bite-sized little waffles of toasted rice have a special crisscross construction that brings out all their crisp, toasted taste. And when you fix Rice Chex up with milk and sugar, you'll find they have a delicate flavor all their own. Rice Chex, the light-sized, bite-sized cereal from Checkerboard Square.
All right, let's go to the scoreboard now, see which is the winning team. According to the checkerboard, Ross Martin, 27, Stubby K, 86. And look at that, cut down from way over 100. True, they won, but down to 30 seconds. The winners and still champions is Stubby K. You did beautifully, Ross. Dennis, I want to thank you. Marilyn, thank you so much. It was wonderful to have you. Don't forget, next week, we're going to have the cast from the Warner Brothers picture PT-109, you know, the life of President Kennedy. So we'll have one team of the Warner Brothers picture challenge, four of our regulars, to see which is the winning team. Now, don't forget, will you please send in letters and let us know how you like this new approach to the game, okay? Till next week, then, Mike Stokey saying bye-bye. See you then.
Bye-bye. Stump the Stars has been brought to you by the Ralston Purina Company, makers of Wheat Chex, Rice Chex, Corn Chex, with all three now available in Chex Mix. Now join us again next week for another exciting, fun-filled session with Mike Stokey and his team of Hollywood champions when they're challenged by the cast of the soon-to-be-released The PT-109, including Robert Culp, James Gregory, Ty Harden, and Grant Williams. Till then, this is Bill Baldwin bidding you goodbye for the entire gang. This has been a Mike Stokey Enterprises production. Goodbye.